Construction management versus civil engineering. This is an interesting question that we're going to answer in this video. So I'm going to talk to you about the differences and why construction management professionals will get civil engineering degrees. So if you're into that, you're going to want to stay right here on this video. So what are the differences? How can you integrate the two and actually use the two? And how can you understand the terminology and then also know where you want to go? So hopefully this video helps you out. If you ever need help, please just reach out in the comment section, but this is what we're going to do. So let me start with construction management. Construction management focuses on the overall management of the project. So if you think about systems, processes, how things are brought together, the administration, the leveraging of resources, that's really what construction management is all about. So it is all about managing the cost, it's about managing the schedule, the quality, the safety on site, bringing people together, managing and maintaining communication, overseeing reports and documentation. It's really the management of the system. So this includes planning and scheduling, budgeting and cost control, procurement of materials and equipment, coordination of subcontractors and workers, making sure we're compliant with safety, making sure we're building in a quality manner, and communicating with clients, trade partners, engineers, and architects, making sure that you're bringing everything together. So to do this, people will typically go to school for construction management within a civil engineering like framework or discipline, or will have a construction science degree. Most of the time I hear that people have civil engineering degrees with a focus on construction management. So that can get a little bit confusing because there's a big difference between civil engineering and construction management. So don't get confused by that. All that is that the department that teaches civil engineering has a wing or a focus or a course curriculum that focuses on construction management. It does not necessarily mean that they are trained to be civil engineers. Before we move on to the civil engineer, I do want you to know that some certifications that you can entertain are the Certified Construction Manager Certification, CCM. You can also get your DBIA certification. You can do CM Lean. There's a number of them out there, but you're going to want to focus on anything that helps you with the management of a construction project, not specifically the engineering. And just one word of warning, I would be very cautious about the PMP certification because it's mostly administrative and not in the focus of what you really need to know to be a great manager. Construction managers can be site managers if you're outside the US, project managers, project engineers, can become operations managers, project directors, project executives, basically managing the overall project. You can also use that degree to become an assistant, superintendent, super, general super, or field operations director. So now let me talk about the civil engineering part. This focus, a civil engineer focuses on the design and engineering, development and maintenance of infrastructure in the civil world. So we're talking about utilities, we're talking about plants, we're talking about roads, bridges, anything in the civil world and the civil discipline. This also includes dams and buildings, which I think is pretty cool. The responsibilities of a civil engineer are as follows: designing infrastructure projects, conducting investigations and feasibility studies, preparing engineering plans and specifications for the project, analyzing data and performing calculations for the design, which is very, very complex and can be tedious, ensuring compliance with engineering standards and regulations, which is quite a big task, supervising construction projects from an administration standpoint to make sure that everything is going in per the plans and specs and per code and regulations, and addressing technical issues and problem solving throughout the project from a civil engineering standpoint for the civil design. This requires a degree in civil engineering specifically, so this is going to be heavy on the math. So God bless you. I don't math very well, so this is quite intense, and there's a lot in there. Certifications can include your professional engineer license, your PE. You could get there by being an engineer in training, an EIT, and any other certification that helps you specifically, or training for that matter, helps you specifically with the design focus that you're interested in and that you're getting the education for. This career path can lead to you becoming a civil engineer, a structural engineer, a geotechnical engineer, transportation engineers, which is super interesting, and environmental engineers. You have a lot of different options with that, and I encourage you to explore those. And you can also, with a civil engineering degree, go into construction management. Like I told you before, all you would have to do is learn the project management skills or have that as a major or a minor. So construction management focuses on the management of the entire site, and civil engineering focuses on designing and engineering civil infrastructure projects. Both fields are super needed. I love both of them, but hopefully this helps you to choose which path you want to go down. The other thing is, I want to invite you, please, to use the comments section below in the video function on YouTube to please reach out if you have any questions. I can connect you with civil engineers, with construction managers, if you want to talk to any of them and get a good idea of where you want to head. I totally encourage you to reach out. Let me also go into, which I think is super interesting, why most construction managers actually choose a civil engineering degree. Number one, it provides a strong technical foundation. And if you know anything about me, you know that I really, really advocate this. I love the strong technical background. I love the understanding of materials. I love the understanding, the math and the calculations and the fundamental engineering understanding of the systems. I always advocate people to go be field engineers, to do survey, to understand these basic concepts. All of these are going to help you to understand the materials, the means, the methods, the math, and how things get built. So it has a very, very strong technical foundation, which number two will make sure that you're versatile and you have a skill set and that you can be more flexible. Like if you ever want to go from construction management to design or vice versa, you can. So it's very, very versatile. So those degrees are very helpful in that way. Number three, the civil engineering background for construction management or just by itself gives you a very, very solid problem-solving background from an education standpoint, which you will need and can use in your role as a construction manager. Number four, obviously credibility and trust. I get asked all the time by people, can I get into construction without a construction management degree or without a civil engineering degree with a construction management focus? And the answer is, if you can get in, you can learn everything you need to learn throughout and be successful. Like for instance, me, I didn't get a degree. I didn't go to a four-year university. I went for a year to learn some basic skills for myself, but I did the certifications, went to the DBIA certification course, learned the CM Lean, CMBIM certifications, learned the applications, learned everything I could for about the field engineering world, survey, layout and control. So I worked my way through. You're still going to have to get the education, right? But I want you to know that this degree really comes with the credibility and trust that will get you in. So it's that piece of paper and it provides the foundation. So the answer is you don't need a degree to be successful in construction, but you might need that credibility and that trust to get the job, get in, get the opportunity, and to get other opportunities from a career advancement standpoint. Number five, and this may not apply to you if you're not doing it, but you will need the degree for certification and licensure. Number six, it will allow you to be flexible in your career and you have lots more opportunities open to you with that kind of an education and background. This is a huge one. Number seven is that you have an understanding of design and engineering, which means that if you're a construction manager, you can pair with them better, which I love. Number eight, you have a competitive advantage within your peers for getting hired, right? So that's definitely going to help you. I see construction management majors or civil engineering majors with a construction management focus getting hired more often and more frequently than the rest of us per se. And really, it could just be an amazing experience and really provide you with the most amount of education while you're there paying for the experience in a university. So I hope you really understand the difference between a construction manager and a civil engineer, but you also understand why a lot of construction managers get a civil engineering degree or a civil engineering degree with a construction management focus. However you plan your college education, that is the difference. I hope it helps. And I also hope that it really helps you to know where you want to go and how you want to start off your career. Because you, if you're coming into construction, you are headed for a beautiful experience if you do it right. And if you put those tools in your tool belt and you get the education that you need. So we're going to put this into a blog post in the description below for you so that hopefully it helps you to make these decisions. Ultimately, I hope it's been a help, please reach out if you need anything. On we go.